Hello students, hope you all are doing well at your homes. So today we are going to start the second part of the poetry, an elementary school classroom in a slum. Surely Shakespeare is wicked, the map a bad example, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal, for lives that slyly turn in their cramped holes, from fog to endless night, on their slag heap. These children wear skins peeped through by bones and spectacles of steel, with melted glass like bottle bits on stones. All of their time and space are foggy slum. So blot their maps with slums as big as doom. The poet here is trying to convince his readers that Shakespeare is a wicked and the map a bad example, as they make the slum children want to go to a world which is inaccessible to them. With ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. Ship and sun here symbolize the joy and happiness which these children are deprived of. Their only experience in life is of hunger and poverty. And moreover, sometimes these children adopt wrong means, even stealing, just to fulfill their dreams. For lives that slyly turn in their cramped holes. That means these slum children live in cramped holes, and every time they are struggling for their survival in these dirty and dingy and filthy rooms. From fog to endless night. That means their morning begins with fog and they have long endless nights. Means their future is blurred. On their slag heap. Slag heap here refers to the piles of the waste materials, and their world is full of garbage and dirt. These children wear skins peeped through by bones and spectacles of steel. That means that their bodies are so thin that it seems as if their bones are peeping out of their skins. And spectacles of steel with mended glass. These children wear the discarded spectacles which are thrown away by the rich people. They mend and repair these glasses and then again they wear them. Like bottle bits on stones means their life is very difficult. It is hard for them to survive in that slum area. Their life is like bottle bits of stones. That means it is shattered, it is broken, and it is like walking on the bottle bits. All of their time and space are foggy slum. That means their world is comprised of foggy slums where they have to live light nightmares. Slums are the only reality of these children, their homes where they spend their whole life. So blot their maps with slums as big as doom. That means their maps, the maps that are displayed in the classroom, are no reality for these children. They cannot locate their slum area in that map. So it is very, very necessary for these children or the slum inhabitants to provide opportunities to lead a dignified and civilized life. Unless governor, inspector, visitor, this map becomes their window, and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs break, oh break, till they break the town and show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands, and let their tongues run naked into books and the white and green leaves open history theirs whose language is the sun. The tone of the last stanza is quite hopeful, because the poet is saying over here that the people like governor, inspector and the visitor, they are the only people who are in power and who can help improve the conditions of these children. The elementary school in the slum exists just for the namesake. The infrastructure is quite poor with hardly any serious teaching. So the poet says that this map, the world map that is hanging inside the classroom, can also become their window, from where they can see the world beyond their slums that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Catacombs here refers to cemeteries. Since the children are confined to the slums, so these sights and glimpses are shut upon them as they are deprived of all the opportunities in their lives. Break, oh break, open till they break the town. Here the poet is hoping that these children will break free from their morbid life. From the chains of the slums, they will break down the chains over there. And he is appealing to the powerful people, those who are in power at present. He just wants these people to liberate these children from dirty slums and enable them to breathe in the fresh, beautiful and healthy environment. And show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold fields, gold sands. The poet wants that the children to get an opportunity to run freely in the open spaces, on the green fields and on the golden beaches, and let their tongues run naked into books. The white and green leaves open, history theirs whose language is the sun. The poet further says that these children should be able to enjoy the fundamental right of education, otherwise their lives will be miserable. So they should be able to learn not only from the book alone, but also from the world, the nature around them. So the poem ends on an optimistic note, and the poet wants opportunities to be available for these children. Students, now let's do a quick revision of the whole poem. In this poem, the poet Stephen Spender shows us that the condition of the children in a slum is pathetic. Their world is far from our healthy and fresh environment. They are like rootless weeds, unwanted and cast out. In the second stanza, the poet describes the classroom, which is also dirty and neglected like its inhabitants. The classroom too exhibits an atmosphere of depression and glum. The walls have portrait of Shakespeare, splendid Tyrolese valley, which is a sharp contrast to the atmosphere of the classroom. These children are trapped in a hopeless situation, and their world is far from the beautiful nature as rivers, valleys and seas. In the third stanza, Spender suddenly attacks Shakespeare and calls him wicked. He says so because he feels Shakespeare has poisoned the children's mind by misleading them that their world is beautiful. The poet feels that the classroom should have pictures of huge slums instead of those cynic graphics. In the final stanza, the poet uses a pacifying tone and appeals to the governor, inspector and the visitors to do something about the condition of these slum schools. The poet wants these children to sail, explore and discover the world so that someday their names are found in the history books. Students, I hope that through this video you all are able to understand this poetry. Now, on the basis of your learning of this poem, you have to complete this worksheet. Thank you.